Hello, hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is Aurora ZX Gaming here, and I just want to introduce you all to my new Let's Play for City Skylines. Today, I am going to be installing our highway system for this city, which will be the area will be known as Sally Bay. So basically, what I'm going to do for this series is I'm going to try and build a semi-realistic city. It's going to be a little kinda sort of realistic. There's gonna be a couple. I'm gonna try my best to be realistic. I'm still kinda working on mastering my detail work. Detail work is a little hard for me sometimes just because of my ADD. but I can tell you I'm very good at designing highways. So basically what we've got today, like I said, is just the basic gist of it will be all highway. This will be the first episode of the highway system. The next episode will be the highway system as well, and it'll also be the completion of the highway system for the most part. And then we'll jump into actual Let's Play with commentary, as we go through the videos. There's a lot of fine-tuning in this. I've been playing City Skylines since it came out on PlayStation. So I would say I'm a little bit better at designing highways and trying to understand the traffic AI in this game than the average player. However, it's definitely a learning curve, and trying to master placing everything properly is quite the challenge. There will be little parts in the actual video itself of me kind of talking through what I'm going through. Just because I feel like there was a lot of me changing the main interchange down there for the toll to get to that little island in the middle. I went through about four or five different iterations of that interchange, and this is about 4 to 5 hours of footage condensed down into roughly 40 minutes. So, definitely quite the challenge to put everything together to where it looks good and semi-realistic, in my opinion. But definitely, if you guys like the video, drop a subscription, maybe give you a like, some comments. I can definitely provide some tips if you guys need me to. I'm also taking suggestions for what I should do in this city. But this is all for now. See you in the next little audio clip. So coming up to this this interchange over here, I investigate the bridge and I see that it's kind of weird and odd looking. Now, I liked the trumpet interchange that was there, so I ended up keeping that same similar design. However, what I did was I just made it to where it was a little more even on each side so that the transitions were a lot smoother. And then when I got out here, I was like, you know what, I really don't want this little island here. So what I did was I ended up having to wait for the water to settle, figure itself out, and go from there. So once I got that completed, I just decided to do some terrain flattening here. You'll see me here turn the daylight back on, basically. but I know flat land is kind of boring, but this central island right here is going to have a campus on it, so I want the land to be nice and flat, as there will be a pretty busy highway running through here, as like I said, the campus for this this map will be here. I decided to boost the highway up. However, what I saw was that the highway was far, the little up part that I did here was a little too large, too high, in my opinion. So what I did was I took that down, and then I dragged the highway across here and tried to balance it out so that it looked real good as far as height and whatnot for the future. So that was the toughest part of the part here, was just to get that part nice and balanced, so where it wasn't too high but it wasn't too shallow either. But I ended up keeping the same trumpet design, and this was actually my first hand-built trumpet design I've ever done, actually. One of my favorite interchanges, I call it the ghost interchange because it looks like a ghost. But now that I've got it pretty well balanced as far as height and everything looks pretty smooth, I've gone to continue over to the other side, and I've lined the towers for the bridges up, smoothed out some land, gave myself a nice big flat plateau here to kind of line up my interchange here. Now here, what I've done is I put them too close, so they were actually clipping through the ground here, so I ended up having to move them back just a tiny bit so that they wouldn't clip. Now, if you have OCD, I'll give you a fair warning. The right side of this interchange right here is significantly longer than the other side. And that's just because I figure that there will be more traffic on that side than the other sides. As that'll be people coming straight to the campus. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and smooth the terrain out to try and get the off-ramps and on-ramps to be relatively smooth. Little intermittent pause there. So this tool that I just used right there, that was the slope tool. That actually is a very nice thing to know how to use now. So what I'm doing here is I'm applying lane mathematics. Shout out to Biffa. I've actually been doing that for a while, but I've never given it a name. So what I'm doing here is I'm just going to add some fences. You see me kind of play with them, figure out which one looks the best. So I'm going to add some fences here to kind of act like guardrails, as there's not really a good equivalent to a guardrail. Throwing in a little bit of details here to try and act like there's a guardrail here to keep people from sliding around if they, you know, happen to be under the influence or, say, a random snowstorm. This is my first time actually doing this, as well. As I usually don't detail my cities, because I usually look at the bigger picture, I don't usually get in real close. As you can see, I'm not very precise, I'm still learning, so we'll kind of go through this together as I learn everything. Trying to add some trees in, make it a little nicer. I like those little bamboo clumps, those are pretty nice. So what you'll see me doing here is I'm actually going to clear out some land, flatten some more terrain out. One of my things that I love to do is I actually really enjoy clearing the trees, because the trees make it a lot easier to clear out the land and make it a lot smoother. This will allow you to better see little rises and dips hiding in the actual trees that you might not be able to see. So what I do here is I go to place down the toll roads, and they're not lining up properly for my liking. And they were too close to the actual interchange itself. So I decided to move them around a bit, and you'll see where they end up resting towards the end of the actual video itself. But I'll kind of be quiet now and watch you guys go through, and let you guys watch me go through this interchange. It's based off of an interchange that I saw in Greensboro. On a recent trip to visit my fiance. However, I ended up not going with that design as it was not lining up properly with the way I wanted it to look in-game. It was a pretty simple interchange, however, getting it to line up properly was not working. But let you guys enjoy this first iteration. Pardon my yawns, goodness gracious. This will be the first iteration of this interchange of two more / three more to go. So as you see here, I'm putting together the last little piece that I thought would complete it and I'd be done with this. However, you'll see me pause here and kind of look over it, and I'm like, I don't like the way this looks. As you see, I completely removed it, decided to start fresh over. This would be the second iteration of this intervention. I'm trying to put it together in my head of how I want it to look, how I want to piece it together, and that's why you'll see me occasionally zoom out, twist the camera around and whatnot. It just looks kind of silly. However, I promise the purpose of that is to show you guys kind of try and piece it together in my head. Go to the digital. Lights up my sweat train now, baby. Come on. So here I'm getting close in my mind to finishing the actual construction of the bridge here. Kind of finagling with these bridges and fighting with them to get them to loop over and fly over each other and everything. This is where the Move It mod would be very beneficial for us console players. So I am sitting here piecing it together with the final bits and pieces, thinking I'm gonna finish and be done with it. However, as stated, this is ending up where I ended up redoing this this interchange about 3 or 4 different times. So I'm just doing some fine-tuning here, trying to get all the lane mathematics and everything to line up properly. I'm very poor at math. So what you just saw there was me settling on, that's good. Alright, cool, we'll move on. So this is me struggling with these toll booths here, trying to place them pretty much right next to each other. So what you see here is I'm actually providing extra lanes going into the toll booth and going out of the toll booth. That way they have plenty of lanes to choose from as they get closer to the toll booth to try and spread that traffic out. This is my first time actually using toll booths, so we'll see if that works in practice. Now this little toll booth on the other side of the bridge here was quite the challenge to line up properly. I ended up actually putting it on the other side with the other toll booth, and you guys will see that in part 2. As well, as I didn't quite have enough space here to line it up properly, and I just didn't like how ugly that turn was right there. Now, even though that could be a realistic thing, I didn't like the way it looked, especially with that big vacant space in between there. I did not like it. So here I'm going to make another trumpet interchange, as I've actually come to really enjoy that interchange. For some reason it's a very nice, smooth, simple interchange in my opinion. So what you'll see here is I struggled a little bit with getting them those little crossovers to go over. Ended up getting them figuring out the trick to get them to work properly. So again, this is me fine-tuning here to try and get everything to line up, which I ended up getting to line up no problem. Ended up having to extend that loop out a little bit further. Got this nice little trumpet there, dual trumpets you could say. And again, this is me fiddling with that toll booth trying to get it to look properly because it just doesn't sit right with me. Decided, nope, let's not do that. Let's just bring the bridge across. But this will be all for part 1. We'll see you all in part 2.